Good morning, everyone. So, because of some power failure issue yesterday, we don't have a class. So, sorry for the inconvenience. And so, in the previous classes, we are trying to discuss auto wiring related information, and we identify the XML auto wiring here, and later we come back to the annotation style here. So, how we can work on the auto wiring using this particular annotation here. So what are the steps we implemented to work on this particular annotations here? So first we'll check with the two configuration files here. So what are the two configs we implemented in the last class? So now we can see this is the XML configuration file called spring configuration file. So here we can observe here how many classes we implemented in this particular configuration file here. Observe carefully. So basically, whenever we are trying to work with this particular XML configuration, what we are going to do, first we'll define this particular bean information, right? So if this particular bean is going to depend on any other bean here, what we are going to do? So we are going to check with which dependency injection is working here, right? So we are having two types of dependency injection here. Based on this particular two types of dependency injection, we need to work on this particular XML configuration file. So for example, if the bean called the greeting service IML, which is going to depend on the other bean with the using the setter injection, right? So whenever we are trying to work with this particular setter injection, what we are going to do? So internally, we are going to work with this particular property tag. Getting the point. So whenever we are trying to work with this particular setter injection, we are going to specify the property tag here. So otherwise, if the beans are going to depends on the using constructor injection, what we are going to do? So we are going to define this particular constructor arg tag here. Getting the point. So these are the basic configuration we identified, and later we move back to the auto wiring concepts here. So you can see by default, like we are having four types of auto wiring concepts. So what are the four types of auto wiring concepts we are having? So by name and by type, as well as constructor and auto detect here. So the auto detect is from the 3.0, it is deprecated here. And we need to focus on the only three auto wiring concepts here. So basically, if I'm going to write here by name here, so how exactly this particular by name auto wiring is going to work here? Getting the point. So this section is very important here. Whenever any beans are going to depend on the other beans here. The simple example here. So we like in the previous example, we implemented company details here. Getting the point. So this particular company details internally, which is going to depend on the employer details here. Right. So whenever we are trying to create an object of this particular company details here, what we need to do here? So we need to create an employee details object also. Getting the point. So why we need to create an employee details object here? Basically, the company is going to depend on the employer object here. The company is going to depend on the employer object here. Getting the point. So this is very important here. But how exactly it is going to depend here? So using this particular setter injection or constructor injection, so this section is very important here that we need to understand here. Basically, while creating this particular employee details object, while creating this particular company details object here, so this particular employer object, which is going to provide it on the constructor level, what we can do? So we can easily understand here. So we are having constructor injection here. Constructor injection here, right? So while creating this particular employee details object here, what they are doing is the container is going to pass this particular employee details object here. So to understand here, now what I need to do, so let me open this particular company details object here. Now you can see internally we are having the company details here. So we are having the details. So this particular section, which is going to provide the dependent object information. Getting the point. So this section is going to provide the dependent object information here. But now you can see on the particular constructor, we don't have any dependence injection here. But where we are having the dependence injection here, we are having this particular setter injection here. Using this particular setQuest method, what we are doing here, we are trying to set the employer related information. So basically, this is the interface here. Getting the point. So this quest is a interface here. Now, what is the implementation class here? So if I'm going to override this, but like implement this particular employee details here, you can observe we are having this particular quest here. The employee details object is implementing from the quest interface here. So this particular quest interface having only one method, something called embark method. The embark method we overridden here. So this section very important here. Now you can see where this is a interface here, and which is having one method, something called embark here. So now we identified here, like how we are making the relation here. Getting the point. So how we are making the relation here. So while creating this particular company details here, what we are doing here? So we are going to call this particular method here to set the employee details object here. So whenever we are trying to use this particular setter injection, how we are going to set in the configuration file here? Using the particular property tag, we are going to set the properties here. We are going to set the properties information. Now we can observe. So how we are trying to set the object information. So this section is going to provide the, so whatever the highlighted code here, which is going to provide the setter injection here. Basically, this section we already discussed in the previous example here. Just for understanding, I'm trying to recap the previous example here. Right. So now using this way, we are going to make the setter injection here. So while setting this particular property information, what happens internally? While creating this particular employee details object here internally, so the container is going to call the setter method to set the employee details object here. Getting the point. To set the employee details object here. Now, what you are understanding here? So this section is going to perform everything. So while creating this particular object here. So while creating, first internally, this object is going to create. And whatever the object we are having, so this particular object using this particular reference here. So careful observe here, we are having the company details called C1 here. Using this particular C1, the container, what it will do, it's going to call the method. So what is the name of the method we are having? SetQuest. So internally, this particular method is expecting one parameter. So what is the parameter which is expecting here? This is expecting employer object here. So we are going to pass this particular employer object here. But here, so as a developer, we are not going to pass any information here. But just we are going to provide the information. So based on this particular information, container is going to create an object and the container is going to call the method while container is going to pass the particular employee object information to this particular method parameter. So everything is going to taken care by the container. But now what we need to do, just we need to share the information. So what are the object we are going to create and how we are going to create object here. So like how is nothing but the dependency injection here, how we are trying to specify here. So this section is very important here. And back to here, by name. So how exactly this particular auto wiring concept will work here? So by name is nothing but name of the property. Getting the point. So whatever the name of the property we are specifying internally, based on this particular name of the property, so it's going to create an object here which is going to inject. So automatically the object's injection is going to perform. So here only the advantage we are going to get here. So explicitly, we are not going to define these two tags here. Whenever we are trying to work with this particular auto wire here, so here we are going to specify the by name or by type or constructor here. So based on this particular auto wire here, what we are going to do? So explicitly, we are not going to write this particular two lines of code here, right? So now what you are understanding is we can eliminate some of the configuration file here. Using this particular auto wipe concept here, what we are doing here? We are trying to eliminate some of the configuration file here. So this section is very important here. And same way we identified whenever we are having the based on this particular name of the property. So what is the name of our property? Now we can see, we'll go back to the same company details here. Now you can see what is the name of the property we are having? Something called details here. Something called details here. So this is the name of the property. Based on this particular property, right? So what happens internally? What happens internally? The injection is going to perform automatically. The injection is going to perform automatically whenever we are trying to work with by name. Getting the point? Whenever we are trying to work with this particular by name property, so name of this particular property, automatic operation will perform here. Same way, second one by type here. Getting the point? So how exactly this particular by type will work here? By type is nothing but what is the type of this particular object here? Getting the point? What is the object type here? Something called we are having interface type here. We are having interface type here. Based on this particular type here, based on this particular type, the object is going to inject it automatically. So without like explicitly, if you are not specifying either the constructor injection or this particular setter injection, so the object is going to inject it automatically. But how it is going to inject it automatically? Based on this particular auto wire. Based on this particular auto wire section here. So try to focus on the highlighted one so that we are going to understand more how exactly this particular auto wire concept will work here. And finally, we are having constructor here. So finally, we are having the particular constructor here. So how exactly this particular constructor will work? Basically, this particular constructor is going to check here whenever we are trying to pass the dependent object information as a parameter of constructor. Getting the point? So whenever we are trying to pass the particular object information parameter here. So now we can understand here how we are going to pass it. So carefully observe here. Now you can see this is the constructor here. This is the constructor, company details here. Whenever we are trying to pass this particular parameters here. Now you can see if I'm going to pass like this here. If I'm going to pass this section here, what happens internally? So we need to work on the particular constructor auto wiring concept here. Getting the point? Now you can see so Eclipse is not responding here. And now, whenever we are trying to specify here the object as a parameter here, we can go for the constructor injection and automatically the constructor, like whatever the object we are having, so this object is going to inject it automatically. Getting the point? So these are the three important sections we discussed in the previous example here using this particular auto wire section here. Right. So only what are the advantages we are going to get here using this particular auto wire here. Now we are going to explicitly eliminate these two lines of code here. So either constructor injection or setter injection, we are not going to write the property and the constructor tag here. So these we have discussed in the previous example, and later we moved into the annotations example here. So to work on this particular annotation example here, what are the changes I made here? Now, if you want to understand here, now you can see here we are trying to work with the XML beans here. So we define this particular context and bean tag here. The same we are going to work with the XML like annotation configuration here. So to understand here, now you can observe here. So spring configuration annotation here. Spring configuration annotation, one configuration file I created here. And inside this particular configuration file, now you can observe, we don't have any auto wire property, or so we did not work on the particular constructor tag and property tag here. So only what are the changes we made here? Only we are trying to define this particular bean information. Only we are trying to work with this particular bean information here. So this section, what exactly it is indicating here? Getting the point. Now what you are understanding here? Whenever we are having this particular dependent beans here, how these particular dependent beans are going to create it? How these particular dependence beans are going to create it? So now you can see inside this particular another package called AutoWire. So what we are doing here? First we need to check with the employees IMPL. Inside this particular employee IMPL, what we are doing here? So inside this particular employee IMPL, what we are doing here? So we are working with one annotation called AutoWire here. Getting the point? So we are trying to work with this particular annotation called AutoWire here. So how exactly we are working on this particular AutoWire? So now we can observe carefully. Whenever, so this particular AutoWire we can provide into the different locations here. The first location on top of the property, we can define this particular AutoWire annotation, and on top of this particular method, on top of the method also we can define this particular AutoWire annotation, and finally we can define on top of the constructor also. Getting the point? So this particular auto wiring annotation we can define into the three locations here. All the three locations we are trying to discuss here. Okay, so let's see the same example. I'm going to run one more time here. I'm not going to use this particular custom. So simply I want to use on top of this particular property. So whenever we are trying to work with this particular on top of this particular property, what happens internally? So basically employee IMPL, which is going to depends on the person object here. Getting the point? So this particular employee is going to depends on the person. While creating this particular employee, what we need to do? We need to set this particular person information here. So in the previous example, to set this particular person information, we provided the information called AutoWire, or we explicitly provided the property tag or constructor tag here. But now we are working on the annotation example here. Basically, whenever we are trying to work with this particular annotation example, so whatever the dependent objects we are having, so those objects are going to configure automatically. Getting the point? So these objects are going to configure automatically. So we don't want to define explicitly. But basically, whenever it is automatically it's configured, what we need to do here? Getting the point? So we need to provide some information to the container. Otherwise, how the container will understand here? If I'm going to add this particular AutoWire here, if I'm going to add AutoWire in our like in the employee IMPL class, how this particular container will understand here? So we are working on the annotation example, or we are working on the XML configuration. Getting the point? So everything, whatever the way, like either we are working on the XML configuration, or if you are working on the annotation example, so annotation related information we need to share to the container, or XML related information we need to share to the container. Right, so see the difference between the annotation find XML configuration. So first difference here, we need to work on this particular context here. So we need to work on the context 3.0 XSD, because in the 2.5 or 2 we don't have any annotation related information. From the 3 only the Spring introduced the annotation configuration information here. So to get the XSD configuration information here, first what we need to do? So we need to change the version to the 3.0, right? So later we need to provide the one context location. Getting the point? Where exactly this particular context is available? We need to provide this particular context information. So these two sections we need to use in our configuration file. And whenever we are trying to use this particular location, we are going to have this particular context colon annotation hyphen config here. So this particular tag we are going to get here. So whenever we are trying to get this particular tag here, what exactly it is indicating here? Basically, we are telling, like we are giving information to the container. So we are working on the annotation based example. Getting the point. So whenever we are trying to add this particular tag here, the Spring container will understand. So this example will contain the annotations related information. Getting the point. So whenever the container will understand the annotation related information, so what it will do? First, it's going to check with what are the annotation we are working with. So what are the annotation we are working internally? We are working on the AutoVire annotation. So what exactly this particular AutoVire annotation will do? Getting the point. So this particular AutoVire annotation, which is going to create objects and which is going to inject the objects automatically. Getting the point. So whatever the beans configuration we are specifying here. So these are the beans we are specifying here. So this particular beans objects are going to be created by the container. And whatever the object created by the container, so those beans are going to be injected automatically. Getting the point. So this particular beans are going to be injected automatically whenever we are going to work on this particular AutoVire annotation. Right. So now you can observe, if I'm going to run the same example here. So where is our main class here? Okay, now you can see we are having AutoVire main here. So if I'm going to run the same example, you can observe how exactly this particular auto wiring is working internally. So you can see this particular get person is called. How this particular get person is called? So first we'll check with the employee MPL object information here. So this particular employee MPL, which is internally depends on this particular person here. Right. So once this particular person is created, now what we are doing here? Now you can observe whenever we are trying to call this particular employee dot get employee method. So whenever we are calling this particular employee dot get employee method, where it will go? So this particular method is going to call. This particular method is going to call. But internally, what we are doing is using this particular person reference. Using this particular person reference, yes, we are trying to call the the person IMPL get person method. So now you can see this is a method, this is the message we are getting or not. So now you can observe the same message or not, get person is called. Now, so we define the get person is called message, the same message we are getting here. But make sure we need to focus very carefully here how this particular person object is created. How this particular person object is created here, right? How it is created here? Because of what we are doing here, we define the employee object bean information and person object information, right? So whenever we are trying to define these two sections here, what happens internally? So these two beans are going to injected automatically because of this particular AutoVire. Now we understand here, I'm trying to comment this section here. I want to work on this particular method related. So method related is nothing but we can call it as a setter injection. We can call it as a setter injection here. So observe carefully if I'm going to run the same example one more time. But now I'm working on the setter injection here. But whenever we are trying to work on the setter injection also, what happens internally? So we are getting the same expected output here. Getting the point. Now I want to check with the constructor related information. So how exactly we can check with this particular constructor related example? Now you can see I'm trying to enable the constructor related information. So I'm expecting here how we are going to call this particular constructor So that this basic example information, already we are aware of it. So we don't want to explain one more time here how this particular constructor will call. Getting the point. So while creating this particular employee IML here, so this particular constructor is going to call. But this particular constructor is not having, like, it is not a default constructor here. So which is having one parameter here. So the parameter here, which is expecting as a person object here, cutting the point. So in the Java, what we are going to do? First, we'll create a person object, and after creating this particular person object here, so we are going to create an employee object while, like, passing this particular person information here. But now you can observe how this particular container is going to create here. How exactly the container is creating internally. So now we can observe, if I'm going to call the same example, we are going to get the same output here. Cutting the point. So we are getting the same output here. Now we need to understand here. So first two beans objects are going to create it. Two beans objects are going to create it here. So first basically, so what it will do the container here. So this particular employee object is trying to create internally. While creating this particular employee object internally, because we are having the parameters constructor which is expecting person object here. Whenever the container will understand here, so the parameters constructor here, what it will do? So it will stop the creation. It will stop the creation of this particular employee object here and back to the person IML. The person IML object is going to create first. And later, whatever the reference we are having, this particular person object here, the reference is going to use to create this particular employee IML here. Getting the point. So these are the two steps is going to perform whenever we're trying to work with the constructor injection here. So this is, we are going to call as a constructor injection here. So this section is very important here, and we need to understand here which scenario, so we can use the constructor injection, and which scenario we can go for the setter injection here. So these are the two important things we need to understand very carefully here. So can you please explain me, so which is the best way to work on this particular injection here? So either the constructor injection is the best way or setter injection is the best way here. So can please, if anyone having an idea, so which is the best one here, you can communicate with me, or you can message me, like, what you are trying to expect here. So why is the constructor here? Okay, so I will explain here, like, the difference between constructor and setter here. For optional dependence, getting the point. For optional dependencies, we can go for the setter method. For mandatory dependencies, we can go for the constructor information. So mandatory is nothing but, basically, whenever we are trying to create this particular employee object here, so we need to create a person object here. So without the person object here, we are not going to create a employee object here. Getting the point. So in this case, we are having the mandatory object called person here. First, we need to create a person object. Using this particular person reference here, we are going to work with the constructor object here. We are going to work with the constructor here. So that we can work on the mandatory purpose here. So whenever we are having, so we need to think before using this particular dependency sections here. So which dependency section we need to use here, right? And some of the optional purpose here. So optional purpose is nothing but, while creating this particular employee object here, we don't want to create any other object here. So we want to create only the employee object information only. And later, whenever we require this particular dependent object information, so we can go for this particular setter injection here. Basically, this particular setter injection, how it is going to call here, with the reference of employee objective. Now you can see something called E1. E1 is the reference of this particular employee objective, and later we are going to call set personally. But here now you can observe here, after creating this particular object only, we are going to get this particular E1 reference here. So while creating this particular employee object here, we are not going to get any E1 reference here. After creating, if some cases, getting the point, we need to call this particular set person to get the particular person object here. Getting the point? So in this case, we can go for this particular setter injection. So most of the time, we are going to call as a optional injections here. So this is a optional dependency injection. And this section we are going to call as a mandatory dependency injection here. So these are the very important here. We need to understand the difference between setter injection and constructor injection here. Right. And back to here. So using this particular auto-void here, we are going to get one more advantage here. So basically, using this particular XML here, we need to work on the name of this particular object information. We need to create the same setter method here. Getting the point. So in the XML configuration here, whatever the property, so which is depending here, the same property name we need to use to create the name of the method here. But whenever we are trying to work with this particular auto-void annotations here, what I am going to do? We can work with any method name. So we can work with any method name. So this particular auto-void section which is going to work happily. Right, now you can observe. So I want to enable auto void here. I want to enable auto void here. Now you can see. So if I'm going to run the same example here, so if I'm going to run the same example, we are getting the same output here. But here the name of the setter method is different here. So the name of the setter method here, some different name I used here, but even though, so we are calling this particular setter method and the object is setting here, and later using this particular person.getPerson method, we are able to call the person information here. So these are the very important dependency sections here. And later, after completion of this particular auto-void annotation, so we created one custom annotation here. So how exactly this particular custom annotation is working? So now you can see, to create a custom annotation, what are the steps we need to follow here? Now you can observe. So this section is going to provide the creating the custom annotation here. And internally, we are working on the auto-void functionality. Whatever the auto-void functionality we are having, the same functionality we are using here. So now you can see, if I'm going to open this particular auto-void configuration. So now you can observe. So this target here, this particular target is providing here, is going to work on the constructor level and is going to work on the field level, is nothing but parameter level, and it is going to work on the method level, and so is going to work on the some of the annotation type here. So these are the four target locations. So we can use this particular auto-void annotation on top of this particular four locations here, like parameter level and method level, constructor level, as well as particular annotation type here. And we can work on the retention is nothing but we can go for the so runtime also. Not only the compile time, the same annotation we can work with runtime also. And another one here, so we want to include the documented or not. In the documentation section, if we want to include, we can write this particular documented annotation here. But now we can see these are the two same here, retention and target here. Now we can observe the retention and target here. The retention and target we are using the same here. But here, why I am using it? We are trying to copy the auto-void functionality into this particular custom annotation. So because of this, what I am doing is I am trying to add on top of this particular annotation. So whatever the annotation we want to copy, so I'm going to add the particular annotation here. And finally, we identified here required annotation. So you can see by default it is true. By default it is true. whenever we are trying to work on this particular autovoid here, what happens internally? So based on this particular B name, the objects are going to inject it automatically. Right. So whenever we are trying to make, like we don't want to make any so automatic injection here, what we can do? We can make this particular required as a false here. So this section we identified in the previous example. If I'm going to make this particular required as a false here, what happens internally? We are getting an exception here. Right. So we'll observe the same example one more time here. But now you need to understand here how we are going to create this particular custom. So later we can check with the required information here. Back to here, inside this particular employee IMPL here, I'm going to work on the custom annotation here. Telling the branch. So this particular annotation we created just now here. Using, if you want to create a one more annotation here, what we need to do? So right click on the particular package name, new, and create an annotation here. So you can see we are going to have an option called create annotation. So which is going to create an annotation here. And here you can specify the what is the annotation we want to create, and you can select here. So type, field, method, constructor, parameter. So where we want to use, we can specify this particular annotation here and add a retention here. So where we want to use this particular, we want to use this particular retention here, as well as we can go for the documented here, and we can go for the comment section here. So these are the very important section we are having here. Now you can see here this section providing the retention, target, and documented, and if you want to add any comments here. So by selecting this particular checkbox here, so we can able to generate the all the properties information here. Using this way, we can create the particular annotation here. Okay, now we understand the creation of this particular custom annotation. So observe here the same example how it's going to run here. Now we are working on the custom annotation here. So using this particular the custom annotations also, we are getting the same output here. Getting the point. The get person is called here. Get person is called here. So these are all for the custom annotation here, and we need to check with this particular required here. So what happens internally? This particular required information. So to work on this particular required information, what I need to do? I want to enable here, because we are not working on the, like inside this particular custom annotation, we don't have any the required information. So observe here. So required here, I want to make false here. So first we need to understand here, what is the exception we are going to get? What is the exception we are going to get here? So sorry, what happens internally? So basically, we need to get an exception here. So why we are getting this object here? Anything we miss here? So I'm trying to expect this particular object. Let me go to the configuration file here. Person one. Let me enable. I want to show you, so what exactly the exception is we are going to get here. So whenever we are trying to work on this particular required false here, sorry, we are expecting the null pointer or no such element exception we are going to get here, but now we are not getting anything here. Let me make it on top of this particular property. We'll observe. So how it is going to work? No, something is wrong. Basically, what I want to explain here, whenever we are making this particular required false here, what happens internally? So this particular dependence object is not like automatically, it's not going to injected by default here. So if the object are not injected by default here, we need to get an null pointer exception here. So now let me make it this particular configuration here. Comment here. Right. So we'll observe whether now we are going to get a yes. We are getting null pointer exception. Observe here. Basically, so we need to comment this particular bean section here. So what I want to explain here, whenever we are trying to work with this particular required false here, what happens internally? So this particular object is not going to injected by default. Getting the point? If this particular object is not injected by default here, what happens here? We are going to get this person. We are going to get this person as a null here. So with the null reference here, what we are doing here? We are trying to call the particular method called getPerson here. So whenever we are trying to call this particular getPerson here, what happens internally? So we are going to get a null pointer exception. Now you can see, so where exactly this particular null pointer exception is coming here. Employee IMPL inside this particular getEmployee method, line number 27. So we are trying to discuss the same line number or not. Now you can see, we are into the same line number here. But now carefully observe, so if I'm going to remove this particular section here, if I'm going to remove this particular required section here, the same example I am trying to run here. The same example I'm trying to run. Now you can see what is the exception we are getting here. So no such bean definition exception we are getting here. So why we are getting the no such bean definition exception here? By default it is a required object here. Because we already identified inside this particular the auto void annotation, we are having required true here. So required true is nothing but what happens internally, wherever we are trying to work on this particular auto void annotations internally, so all the beans are going to injected automatically. If the bean is not available here, what happens internally? So we are going to get an exception here. Getting the point? If the particular bean is not available here, we are going to get an exception here. Now you can see no qualifying bean type person here. Telling the point, no qualifying bean type person, so found in the dependency. Telling the point, so basically we are working on the dependency injection using this particular auto void here. So you can see expected at least one bean which qualifies the auto void. So we are the container is giving information here, so we need one bean to qualify this particular auto void here. Right, now you can see which is giving an option here, make this particular auto void false here. If you are not interested to provide this particular bean information here, you can go and do provide this particular required false here. By default it's providing the required true here. So this section is very important here. If I'm not interested to make this particular dependency section here, what we can do? Simply, we can go for this particular auto void and we can make this particular required false here. So carefully observe, if I'm going to make the required false here, we are getting the difference exception here. And if I'm removing this particular required here, we are getting the difference exception here. So these two say exception, we need to understand very carefully here. Right? And finally, we implemented the important section here, something called qualifier annotation. So how exactly this particular qualifier annotation is going to work here? how exactly this particular qualifier annotation is going to work. Let me open this particular okay, let me comment this particular qualifier annotation now. So I'm going to enable this particular custom annotation here, and in our configuration file, not this configuration file, so in our configuration file, if I'm going to have two beans, getting the point, if I'm going to have two beans here, what happens internally? So you can see we are having the two person object information, right? We are having two person object information we are creating here with the ID different to ID, with a different ID. So we'll observe the same example I'm going to run here. Observe here what happens internally. Again, we are getting a different exception. In the previously, we identified no such bean definition exception, but now we are getting no unique bean definition exception. So see the exception very carefully. Previously we got no such bean definition exception, but now we are getting no unique bean definition exception here. Right. So by seeing this particular exception, we need to understand here. So where we did some mistake here. Right. No unique bean definition exception. So now what we need to do? So to understand this particular no unique bean definition exception, so now you can read this particular information. No qualifying bean type, something called person. So is defined, where it is defined here. Right. So this particular type of this particular person is defined. Right. So which is expecting single matching bean, but we found two beans here. So carefully observe here. So whatever the bean type we are expecting, the same bean type we are matching here. But here, so we are expecting single matching bean. Getting the point? We are expecting the single matching bean here. But now we got two here. We got two. So sometimes here, what happens here? So more than one, the same person object we are going to create. More than one, the same person object we are going to create here. So whenever we are trying to create, so we may get this kind of exception, something called no unique object creation exception here. So to handle this kind of exception, what we need to do? Getting the point? To handle this kind of exceptions here, we need to go for this particular qualifier annotation here. So whenever we are trying to work on this particular qualifier annotation here, so we need to specify the particular bean ID. We need to specify the particular bean ID here. So the whatever the bean ID we are specifying, the particular bean only which is going to injected here. So you can see on top, like below, so this particular get person is called here. Below we can see we are able to get the expected message here. So this very important section we are discussing here. Now initially we discussed with the autovide here, and later we work on the custom annotation, and later we are working with the qualifier annotation. Cutting the point. So these are the very important section we are discussing here. So anyone having any questions regarding this particular autovide and custom annotation and qualifier annotations here. So three annotations we are discussing here. Any questions? Okay. So we don't have here. What I want to do, I don't want to add these two informations also. So now you can explain me, like without adding this particular bean, getting the point. So without adding this particular bean here, so what I need to do? Without adding this particular bean section, I want to create object and I want to run the same example here. So to work on this particular example here, what I want to do? So first, we need to discuss the component scan here. So we need to discuss the component scan information here. So before discussing this particular component scan information here, now I want to check if someone is trying to message. So if we need to both person and object, person one object. If we need both person and sorry, I did not understand here exactly your query. Can you please elaborate a little bit more?
Yeah, can you hear me?
Yes, tell me.
Yeah, if we need both objects, while we are using that qualifier annotation, we are specifying which object we need, which bean.
Yes.
Person and person one. Maybe sometimes yes. We need some cases how we can get both objects, both beans.
See, the qualifier annotation is going to provide the conflict only here. So instead of using the two beans at the time, so just use any one of them. So that is where providing the information using this particular qualifier annotation.
Okay.
So if we want to use the both objects at a time, what we can do? Again, we can go for the setter injection or constructor injection. You can create the two injections and provide. So that is a good option here.
Okay. Yeah, got it. Thank you.
Okay. Back to here. So we need to discuss the component scan. So basically, the component scan is going to provide the packages related information here. So whenever we are trying to provide the package here, what happens internally? The container will understand here. So we are not going to create any bean here. So we are having some of the stereotype annotations here. So we'll try to discuss what are the stereotype annotations we are having. And we are going to work with each stereotype annotations here. Okay. And before going to discuss the stereotype annotations here, first we need to provide the configuration information first. So to provide the configuration information here, we need to work on the context:component:scan here. So context:component:scan here. Now what I'm doing here? So here you can see which is expecting one attribute call base package here. So inside this particular base package, we need to specify the package information. So why we need to specify the package information? Because inside this particular package, we are going to work on the stereotype annotations here. Inside this particular package, we are going to work on the stereotype annotations here. Whenever we are trying to work with this particular stereotype annotations here, what happens internally? The container will understand this particular component scan here. So once this particular container understands the component scan here, where it will go? So whatever the package name we are going to specify here, so it's going to identify the package information. Internally, it's going to check with the stereotype annotations here. On top of this particular class, if we make any stereotype annotations here, the container is going to create object of each stereotype annotations for the particular classes, whatever the classes we are going to create inside this particular package. So the same example you can observe here. So I want to create the package name called com.javatechnology.here. So we are going to work with a different package here. So what is the different package here? So let me provide component scan. So this is the package I want to provide, right? Let me create a package here first. Here I want to create one package here. Now we created the package here. So inside this particular package, what we are going to do? So we are going to create a classes here. So to create a classes here, first what we need to do, and to create the classes here, okay, let me create an interface first. And so what exactly the interfaces I'm going to create here. So something called, we are going to work on the instrument here. So again, I want to work with the instrument annotation here. So this particular instrument will have one method called split, and I'm going to work with one class here. So something called so guitar is a implementation. So I want to work with the instrument here. Whenever we are trying to work with this particular instrument here, we need to override this particular guitar here. And so let me add some message here. So whenever we are trying to play this particular guitar here, so we are going to get some sound here, something. So this is not the expected sound here. Just for understanding, I'm trying to write here. Right. So, but now here I want to create one more here. I want to check with some members. Instead of person, we can go for the member here. So member is having one interface here, and so here also I want to check with void. Let me create a implementation class here. So now IMP. So it is nothing but implementation class here. Here I want to private so instrument here. Using this particular instrument here, what I'm going to do? So I'm going to call the play method. Getting the point. So now you can observe. So this particular member is expecting instrument object here. Right. So here what we are going to do, we are going to work with the stereotype annotations here. So first we need to check with what are the stereotype annotations here. So we are having four types of stereotype annotations here. The first one here, component here. So let me add first all the stereotype annotations here. And repository. So now you can see we are having four kind of annotations here. So each one will have specific purpose here. Cutting the fun. So this four we are going to call as a stereotype annotations here. So first we'll check with how exactly the each stereotype annotation is going to work. So to understand this particular stereotype annotations here, so first we need to check with the component. Basically, this is the general purpose of this particular stereotype annotations here. So like basically, which is going to indicating here, this is the particular bean component here, right? So whenever we are trying to work with our general purpose here, so we can use this particular stereotype here. And the remaining all the annotations are going to extended from the this particular component annotations here. Getting the point. So what we can do for the general purpose here. So there is no specific purpose of this particular component annotation here. So just for creating a bean object here, what we can do, we can specify this particular component annotation. And later, controller annotation. So we are having this particular specific purpose here. Basically, this particular controller annotation we are going to use in the MVC classes here. The MVC controller classes here. Basically, whenever we are trying to send any request here, the particular request is goes to the controller class here. So to give the information to the container, what are the our controller classes? Getting the point. So what are the our controller classes? To specify the controller classes, how we are going to specify using this particular controller annotation, we are going to specify the classes as a controller. Right. Same way service here. So basically, this particular service here, most of the time we are going to work on the business logic here. So what exactly the business logic will have here? Getting the point. So this particular business logic here, we'll try to discuss here whenever we are trying to work on the MVC related applications here. Getting the point. So as of now, we are not going to understand what exactly the business logic we are going to write here. Getting the point. So we have in the MVC classes here. In the MVC classes, we are going to discuss the service related information. And back to here, the final one called repository. Basically, we are going to work with this particular repository annotation on top of the DOO classes here, database related classes only. So we don't want to write this particular repository classes on top of the service classes here. So sometimes, getting the point, for the small application which is going to get it will work successfully, but sometimes we are going to get exceptions here. So whatever the expected output we are getting here, we are not going to get here. Getting the point. So because of this, so we need to work on the wherever the particular repository, like the particular annotation is specified here. Getting the point. Now we need to understand each annotation here. So let me add, first we'll go for the general purpose annotation, something called component here. So in the remaining annotation, we are going to get in the MVC related applications here. You can see component we are having. Component we are having. So whenever we are trying to specify this particular component here, what happens internally? The container will understand this particular class and is going to create an object of this particular member AMPL class here. Getting the point. So here, what we need to do? So we need to specify the name of this particular component here. So why we need to specify the name of this particular component here? Getting the point. Basically, using this particular application context here, we are trying to load the particular bean information. So to load this particular bean information, we need a name of this particular bean here. So something here, I am going to provide the bean here. Something called member here. And we need to work on the autovide here. So again, we need to work on the autovide. Why we need to work on the autovide here? We are working on the dependency injection. Getting the point. So these two sections we need to provide here. And here also, we need to provide the on top of this particular getter. Getter also we need an object here. Getting the point. So we need to create one instrument object here. So that is called getter here. Let me add the component annotation on top of this particular getter here. So here, if you want to load this particular getter object here, you can specify the name here. So otherwise, you can use. So whenever we are not specifying here, so internally, the container is going to use the camel case style, something of the first letter of this particular class is going to use as a small letter and the remaining letter as this is going to use here. So to find out the name of the bean, what we can do? Simply, first we need to check with the bean name and we need to change the first two letter of this particular class as a small letter here. So this is the way the objects are going to be created internally. Okay, and let me change this particular IMPL, the particular member information into configuration file. I'm not going to add any information here. So I'm commenting everything here. We'll go for the main class. Here I want to. So I want to use this particular container information here. what we are going to use is member here. So we need to work on the member. Member dot get member. So we are getting an exception here. Okay. So again, we are getting a version related information here. What happened? New Java class file. Here, inside this particular component scan, I want to create one more something called component scan name. So we'll observe so basically this is not related to our example here. So this is something called the class related information we are getting here nested probably due to new Java class file version that is not supported yet. Guitar component scan. What happened internally? So Spring configuration annotation we are working here. Nested IO exception. Yes, some class reader failed to call the class file. New Java class file version. So we did not change any version here. Okay, so we'll try to run. Component scan. Nervo.gy, com.java technologies. Everything is correct. Class path scanning candidate component provider. Simple metadata. Yes, some class leader failed to pass class of probably new Java file. Which version? We are working on the 1.10. Why it's giving an error here? Okay. Everything is correct. Libraries. Okay. So let me clean the Maven. We'll observe. So why we are getting this? Okay. What is the command we can give? Okay, Spring Core AR. So we don't have any Spring Core AR here. So why it is creating the default instance here? Something is missing. Let me run the same example. Oh, file is not founding. So why the file is not founding? Okay, so we'll check tomorrow. Basically, we did not change anything inside this particular file, and I need to check here different packages created here. Why this particular different package is created? Need to understand here. So inside this particular M2 repository Spring Code. Why this particular folder is created? Spring Code. Yeah. Spring Core, target Spring Core, MVQ Info, Spring Core, yeah. Okay. So let me run final time. File not found. Why this file is not found in? It is in the same transfer directory. So basically, it's a version related error we are getting here. Observe, we are getting here. So everything we copied here, we did not change anything. But sometimes we are going to get this kind of exception. We need to resolve here. But now observe, we can go, like first we check with the configuration file. So what you are understanding inside this particular configuration, only two tags we specified here. We identify this particular first tag, which is going to indicating here. Whenever we are trying to work with automatic annotation here, we need to specify this particular context colon annotation config here. And later, the another one component scan here. So why we are using this particular component scan here? So whenever we are trying to work on this particular component scan, internally, any stereotype annotation we are going to work here. So those stereotype annotations, all the bins are going to create it. And so whenever we are working with any dependence injection, the dependence injections also is going to complete it. And we are ready to use the particular bins information. But how we are going to use? And by default, as I explained here, the container is going to use the camel case style here to get the BA information here. Otherwise, if you're not interested here, what we can do, we can provide the name like this here. So whatever the name we are going to provide here, based on this particular name, the beans are going to create here. Right, so it's nothing but, so this particular member, which is going to act as a reference of this particular member object here. The same thing here, in our component scan, something called member main class here, what we are doing here? Using this particular getBean method, we are going to, we are adding the reference information here to load this particular bean information here. Right, so using this particular bean, we are loading in a member object and we are calling the particular member information. But this very important section we are discussing here, so without adding any bean configuration, like the bean tag information here, we are trying to work on the simple example here. So any questions regarding this particular bean information? Okay, so we'll continue tomorrow the remaining stereotype example here. So how exactly the remaining stereotype exams are going to work here? Right, so once it is completed, we'll check with the Java configuration example here. So how exactly we can work on the Java configuration here? After completion of this particular Java configuration, we are going to work on the another module here. So we are going to complete the Spring Core module here. So once it is completed, we'll move on to the DO module here. So using the DO module, first we are going to check with the Spring JDBC and later Hibernate, getting the point. So this is the way we are going to communicate with the examples here. Okay, so we'll continue tomorrow the remaining sections.